Hi. So let's continue. And in this video, we're going to see how we can import subscribers into our new Getresponse account. The first thing I want to do is to create a new campaign which will house these new contacts. So to do that, I'll just go into create campaign. And the next thing is you give the campaign a name, and let me call this one new students. Then create campaign. So it must be all lowercase. New students. You can use numbers and the underscore if you want to. So in this case, the first thing I want to do is to add contacts. So you can click here, or for me, I want to come here and say import contacts. So there are three different ways in which you can import a contact into your Getresponse account. So the first one is copy and paste. If you have a lot of emails and they're on a text file like this, you can just copy all of them and then come and put them in here. But the first thing you have to note is that they have to be separated. If you're going to use this method, they will have to be separated using a comma. So, for example, if this is the first contact, so you'll have the email, then let's say that's the first name. You can use it just like that as one name, or if you want this to be two different names, you will put there another comma. But in this case, I want this to be one name. So let me add a comma there and use a space, add another comma. So the comma will let Getresponse know that this is one field, that is another field. So they have to be well organized. You see, the emails are coming first and then the names are coming second. The email first, name second, email first, and name second. So I will Control A, Control C to copy this, and then if I bring it here and click on, I give my word that I have permission to copy this list. After doing this, I can just import the contacts. And then now you can see that you'll need to give the fields a name. So for example, these ones will automatically be detected as email addresses, and they will appropriately be labeled as email address. So this will be one field. This field needs to be given a name. So these were names. So I'll just come here and look for something like name. Yeah, I can choose name. And if you see this, if you come here, we look at our import, you'll see that the first one was Bizanosa Gmail and the name was Bizanosa First. So they have been aligned correctly. And if you have a lot of them, they will all be aligned correctly. So if there were other fields, you could add a custom field. Maybe you want to add a certain field and it is not within these ones. You can also add custom fields. Maybe you want to add something like title. Do you have title? We don't have title. So if you want to add something like title, you can add title and then you can give it the same value, title. This is what will be used for storage in Getresponse. So if I say add, it will add this value of title. And since I don't need it, I'll just click here to delete it. Now, we've given this one a name. If you had other fields, you'd have to also give them labels. This field labels. Okay. So let's go to the next step. So if I click next, and then you can choose the campaign where you want it to go. Maybe for you, you have premium members and free members. You'd be able to choose where you want the list added, because you don't want to mix your premium members and your free members. So in that case, you just choose the right campaign. In my case, I just want to use these new students. And then if I had autoresponders, I would be able to click here, add into cycles on day, and then I would choose the autoresponder. But in this case, I don't have any autoresponders created, and therefore this would not make any sense for me. So after all this, I can just click on finish import. Import successful. So now that you already have contacts in the campaign, you can create a newsletter and send to them, or you can import more contacts. So what I want to do is I want to go back here into import more contacts. So in this video, we have seen how you can import your contacts using copy and paste. In the next video, we're going to see how you can upload a file. And then in the next one, you're going to see how you can use other services if you already have contacts in those services, how you can just link to them and then import those from those services, from these services. So we'll just brush up on this later on after we look at how you can import a file. For example, you have a CSV file that you have exported from another email marketing platform, for example, MailChimp. So we're going to look at that in the next video. So in this video, we've just seen how you can import via copy and paste. But what I want to do is I need to go and delete the contacts that have imported, because the next ones that I'll be importing will be the same as the ones I've just imported. So I can go into contacts, and let me go into search contacts. And then let's say view all contacts. And the contacts that we want are, so in this case, I want to remove this. Since I know them, I can just remove them manually. And once I select them, I can click on action and I will click on remove from account. Okay. So a word of caution, since the emails were all similar and I selected remove from account, it removed everything from the account. If you want to remove them just from the campaign, make sure you just remove them from that particular campaign. But if you want to remove them overally from your Getresponse account, you click on remove from account. But if you only wanted to remove them from one campaign, make sure you say remove from campaign. So in the next video, what you're going to do, we are going to see how we can import the same contacts as a file upload. So I'll see you then.